never forget the pain that Yahiko suffered. And now, this world shall know pain.
Justice. You strive for your own sense of justice. And I strive for my own version of it. So do you finally comprehend pain now?
Hey, what's goody, you two? It is your boy, I Don't Miss. I haven't uploaded in like a week or a couple days, you feel me? I've been busy trying to play some rep grind, but I'm back now, back to make some videos, you feel me? So today, this video is not even gonna be like the videos I post. This is gonna be the top 10 worst badges and the top 10 best badges, in my opinion. Remember to subscribe, bruh. Please subscribe. Look at the people who are not subscribed, who watch my videos. Come on, we can do better. Like, bro. So subscribe, leave a like. Remember all that. Instagram, be linking the bio. Try to follow that Instagram. But yeah, comment down below if you think I missed out on any badges, or if you like a certain badge over what badge, or if you don't think a badge is bad, but yeah, just comment down below your thoughts on this video. Share it. Yeah, without further ado, let's get into the video. Now for the first worst badge, bro, I think it's off-ball pest. Now, I'm going to say off-ball pest because, first of all, I don't use it, okay? You know, any of my builds that play defense, I never put it on. Now, the badges for, like, if your man doesn't have the ball, you cling on to him, you don't let him get open. At the same time, bruh, like, I'm gonna keep it real. Like, you can do that without the badge anyways. Like, anytime I play rec or park, I'm always on my man anyways. So it's not like they get open off ball. They don't, like, nobody jukes me off ball and gets open. They just use screens nowadays, or they just sit corner. So there's no point in you having this badge, at least in my point of view. Maybe if you're like a 2K league player and people run plays, I guess you could do it, but for me, in part, it's either use screens or the dude sit in corner. So you're not gonna need this badge. But yeah, that's the first badge that's worst, in my opinion. Now the next badge that is the worst, in my opinion, is ice in my veins. Now, most, let's say, shooting builds only have, excuse me, around 20, maybe, or 17 badges, like 20 something. 17 or maybe even 30 if you pick up a pure shark. But to me, I'm not gonna waste my badge upgrades on a free throw badge that only works in the fourth quarter. Because when I play rec, we either blow them out or I blow them out. And we don't shoot free throws in park unless you love my career, but that gets boring. So I mean, if you're gonna be in rec, at least, like, blow them out. Like, we blow them out or we get blown out. So we don't really need free throws. And sometimes we do need free throws. Most of the time, they make it because, yeah. But, I mean, I can't really see this badge being useful to me. In my eyes, comment down below if you think any different. But, yeah. Now, for the next badge, we have Teardroppers. Bruh, this is not 2K19 anymore. Like, nobody does freaking floaters, but I'm sorry, I don't like, anytime I see somebody do a floater, it'd be like the rookies or the pros, and then they make it one time, they do it again, they get contested and they miss. So I think this is one of the worst badges, because if you, bro, if you're gonna be a finishing build and you waste your upgrades on this badge when there's so many other badges out there that you could put on, then that's just not, I don't know why you would do that. But yeah, I think this is one of the worst badges because it's just kind of useless. I mean, you might get one or two buckets off of this, but the third time you do it, you're gonna get contested. It's not an automatic. Now, if this was like a cheated move, like the hop step, then I guess it would be useful, but it's not. So yeah, that's why this one is one of the worst badges. Now for the next badge, bruh, my God, this is steady shooter. Now, when I started this YouTube stuff and I did my mixtapes, y'all would see I made a lot of contested greens. And that was because I used to have this badge on Hall of Fame. Because I thought this badge decreases, I thought it used to decrease penalties off of contested shots and boost open shots. But it actually doesn't, it's the opposite. So it boosts your contested shots. So when you shoot contested shots, it helps you, right? But at the same time, it decreases the chances of you making a wide open shot. That's why if you use any NBA players, like, and you make an open shot, it's kind of hard. If you have meter on, it's going to be kind of difficult. They all have steady shooter on. So when I had this badge, I used to miss a lot of open game winners, a lot of just open shots. That's why it's one of the worst badges, because, like, in 2K, you should be all about shooting open shots. It shouldn't be contested after contested shots. You should be able to get yourself open. And that's why this is one of the worst badges, because, like, my point four only has 12 badge upgrades. I'm not going to put my badge grip upgrades on steady shooter to help me shoot contested. I'm supposed to be getting myself open. So, yeah, that's why this is not a good badge, in my opinion. This next badge is pick and popper. So, it's basically when a big man or, like, a shooter, like a power forward center, will set you a screen and pop. Now, one of my friends put this badge on to try it out, because they said in another 2K it was good. So we put it on. He set me a screen and pop. What happened? Brick. And this is one of the badges that don't pop up when you actually use it. So I say it's one of the worst badges, because if you're a good shooter, you don't need to put a badge on to boost that. You shouldn't need it. Range extender and quick draw are the only good badges you need for shooting. So I don't think you need pick and popper, because, like, if you're a good shooter, you shouldn't need this. But yeah, simple. For the next worst badges, in my opinion, is Deadeye. Now, when I had my 3-level score, all 30 badges, I'm not gonna lie, I did have Deadeye on Hall of Fame, bruh. But after that, when I started liking ISOing, and when I started making my playmakers, like my mid-range playmaker, my point forward, I didn't need Deadeye. And the reason was because I was ISOing. I was getting myself so open. Like, I would miss. It would say wide open. Deadeye is for when people close out on you. So I guess if you're a catch and shooter, you're sitting at the hash, you shoot, and it says 20%. I guess that's why you can use Deadeye. But for me, when I ISO, I don't need Deadeye, because I'll be butt naked open. So that's why I think Deadeye is one of the worst badges. I don't need Deadeye on my playmakers, because I'm always wide open when I shoot. And even when I'm not wide open, y'all seen my clips, I be making those contested shots. That's not even with Deadeye. That's just with them not playing hands up, because I know when to shoot. But yeah, that's why this is one of the worst badges, in my opinion. Now, this next badge, cross key score, bro, I don't think this is useful at all. Like, it only pops up for me when I take those short corner fades. But other than that, I don't even see this badge pop up. What is this badge for? It says it boosts your percent when you're running across the paint. So maybe that's for reverse layups. I don't know. But even when I do reverse layups, this never pops up. So I think this badge is straight useless. I'm never going to use this badge. Like I only put it on because it helps for my fades. But, like, that's, like, very close to the basket. And when I do shoot those, most of the time they're contested. And it just gives a little bit of boost. But that's why I think cross key score is useless. I don't think you need it at all. Now, I don't even know why they put Trapper in the game. Trapper is just useless. Nobody traps. Like, in this 2K, people either use screens, like I said, or ISO. So you're not even going to have a teammate ready to trap. Like, you don't even going to need this. And it's because I play Park. Maybe if you play Rec all day, I guess. But, like, why are you double teaming somebody? You shouldn't have to double team anybody. You should be able to guard your man unless they got 40 on you. But I don't know. They shouldn't even put Trapper in the game. Like, nobody traps. Like, who traps in 2K? Like, what the... For these last two... We have Pass Fake Maestro and Pump Fake Maestro. Now, bruh, they are both useless to me, because first, I don't pump fake. When I do pump fake, I just do it so I can, like, just start dribbling again. But this badge, it lowers the percent of cover after you pump fake. So that's just dumb. I'm not putting my badge upgrades on this badge to pump fake. And then for the Pass Fake Maestro, like, they already think you're about to pass fake, and they already run off even without the badge. Like, I don't even have the badge. I be doing pass fakes. They run over to the other dude. So that's why I'm saying you don't even need both of these badges. So they're just, like, bad. I don't even know why they put them in the game. But now, moving on to the best badges. Now, for the top best badges, we have Quick Draw and Range Extender. Now, it's pretty self-explanatory. Quick Draw speeds up your jump shot. Range Extender gives you a better chance of making it from farther away from the hoop. So you have to think about it this way, right? Without both of these badges, how could you shoot the ball? You can't shoot the ball without these badges. So that's why I put these as the best badges. Now, I technically think these are the only badges you need to shoot. Like Green Machine, Hot Zone, those are all, like, additions. But these two are the main two. Like, they're the best two. So without these badges, you can't shoot. The reason I put Fancy Footwork up here as one of the best badges is only because it bails me out sometimes. Now, on defense, I should have put this as the worst badge, because people just abuse this, and then when you're right there, they make the contested shot. Because if you have this on gold plus go Hall of Fame, you're going to make like the 20, you're going to make the 30% contested. So that's why I put it as best, because sometimes when I do hop steps, it kind of glitches me in front of them sometimes. And without the badge, you probably won't give me that animation. So I'm going to put that there because, you know, it bails all of us. You know what I'm saying? You get clamped and you just tap that X button. You just boom, boom, hop step past me like you're like, yes, yes, you know. And that's why I put it as the best badge. I mean, one of the best badges, because it just bails people out. So, yeah. Now, this next badge is Slithery Finisher. Growing up. Bruh. I put this as one of the best badges because, well, like, if you think about it, all them times you go baseline, bruh, and, like, you make them, like, put their hands up and it glitches you to the basket, that's what Slithery Finisher does. All them times you do, like, a Euro step, hop step, like all those times, and they just get stunned. Slithery Finisher kind of stuns them. So especially, just think about when people go baseline on you and it makes you like put your hands up. That's Slithery Finisher right there. Or when they go up for a dunk and you think they're about to do a layup and it just like puts them into a dunk animation. That's Slithery Finisher. So a lot of the times for y'all finishers, this badge does help y'all. And it doesn't even pop up a lot. It's one of those badges that stays down. It doesn't pop up. But if you really know what this badge does, you'll know why I put it as the best badge. Well, since I do dribble, I'm going to say Quick First Step. You already know. It's one of the best badges in the game. That's how you speed boost. That's literally how you speed boost. You can't speed boost without this on Gold Hall of Fame. So that's why I put Quick First Step on here. Now, you have to think about it. Just like Quick John Ranger Standard. Without this badge, how are you going to dribble? Like, there's no way for you to dribble or speed boost or get past people. Y'all know sometimes y'all like zigzag and then y'all just get past them. Like, and it's a close game. Y'all like, yes. Y'all get like, when y'all get a blow by, that's Quick First Step. That's why I put it up here. Now, another badge that's very good, in my opinion, is Brick Wall. Now, we got to give some love to our centers, right? So, y'all all remember when y'all couldn't dribble, y'all getting clamped. Y'all center comes at y'all big body. The dude is out here falling on the floor. That's Brick Wall. So, I ISO. So I could put this as the worst badge, but I'm only saying Brick Wall is one of the best because I used to use screens before. And without this badge, do you know how many people wouldn't be able to score? Like, if you think back, like, if you really think, there's so many people that just use the Curry size to go left, right on the screens. They would not be able to score. Now, to me, I think that's a good thing if they was to remove this badge, because it would show who's, like, skill and who's not skill. But without this badge, like, so many people would not be able to score because... Me, I want to put Pick Dodger on. I'll be on him the whole game. But yeah, I think Brick Wall's up there because our centers do be sending some big bodies. When you're on offense, like, you're always going to say, oh, I don't like Intimidator. I don't like Intimidator. But you have to think about it, right? Y'all know all them times y'all be on defense and y'all guarding somebody, right? And they take up a layup and you just like, oh, he made that. And he misses. And you're like, yes, like, because that's Intimidator, bro. I'm trying to tell you. Y'all remember 2K19? Them stretches, they would shoot right over you. Go watch Duke Dennis. He was shooting over people. Freaking people would just go into the paint and just lay you. Like, I had a 6'10 point forward last year. I would just lay point guards. Like, it was no contest. Like, the contest system was broken last year. Hands-up defense didn't even really work like that. If you had take, you going green over people. But, like, now with Intimidator, bro, like, I think it's a little bit better. So, I feel like if they would have had Intimidator in 2K19, that could have been the best 2K. But... I just like how it's a little bit more balanced because Intimidator gives that contest that last year didn't have. So that's why I think it's one of the best badges. All the badges I have for y'all today. Now, there could have been a lot more best badges in y'all opinions. Y'all can go down and comment them. But for my best badges, what I was thinking is, what is a must-have badge? A badge that if you didn't have would affect your game. So that's all I was thinking about. But if there's more badges, y'all can comment down below. If y'all thought one of the badges I talked about that I said was bad, if y'all think it's good, comment down below if you think it's not bad. But that's all I got for y'all today. Subscribe, like, turn on post notifications. Let's try to get to 300 subs before 2K21. That's my goal. That's all I got for y'all. And I'm out. Peace.